I think my ability to move up and down the ice and my vision separates me from the other players, and like my ability to play offensively as well as defensively.
I think one of his best attributes is his vision. He moves the puck incredibly well on the ice. He sees the ice really, really well. He's got that hockey sense that's really, really hard to teach. Simon just gets it.
He is Simon Herz, a leader on a very good team and an all-star defenseman, self-made and hockey humble.
His first attribute that you have to be good in life and anything, he's a hard worker. He's one of our hardest workers in practice. He skates incredibly hard and sets the tone for everybody else.
I've had the trouble with confidence in playing offensively previously, like last year and maybe like 2 years before, and I've just gotten more confident joining the rush.
He's added offensive capabilities this year, which is nice, and helping us out really in any way he can, like you saw. So some games we need him to score, and other days we need him to just stay back and protect our net.
Herz is one of the top point totalers for Chap Hockey, one of the many reasons he will compete as a Team Colorado All-Star in the CCM National Invitational Tournament in April.
I expect it to be really fun. I'm very honored to be selected by Gwazdecki and Otten Woodley. I can't wait to represent Team Colorado and Colorado hockey in general.
They followed him along the way, making sure he's doing the little things along the way to continue to be in that light. If he didn't, I think they would absolutely be choosing guys that deserve it, and he's one of them. So they followed up with him. They see him as one of the guys that can help them be successful on their trip this year, and it's really special for him to be able to do that.
I think we could prove that we're one of the top hockey states, and that Colorado is really good hockey, and that I think we'll be able to prove that in Minnesota.
First, the local goals for a young program that made the Frozen Four in two previous years of Chassa existence. 2020, maybe more.
Cautiously optimistic is the word that we use around here this year. We are cautiously optimistic about this bunch. They're really tight. They seem to work together as a team.
You've had some talent in the short lifespan of this program. What's changed from last year to this year? It seems a little different.
Yeah, it seems really different to me as well. Last year we were more individual and skilled. This year we're still really skilled, I think, but we're more of a team and we play together and we all focus on the same thing.
They're picking up some things that we've started from the very beginning of the year. A couple of our models are just all in, all the time and all together. And it starts with Simon, right? He does the little things right.
One of the little things is a sweet and sour tradition passed down from an old Denver Pioneer to a former pupil who is now the head coach of a group of young skaters from the town of Parker.
So at the end of each week, we do a shootout game, orange lemon. The winner of the shootout gets to eat the orange, but then the loser of the shootout has to eat the lemon.
If you score, you get to go to the orange line in the first round. If you miss, you go to the lemon line. In the orange line, you get to keep shooting. If you keep scoring, the winner, whoever gets the most goals or continues scoring, gets the orange. That tastes delicious. It's sweet. The lemon is the opposite of that. So if you keep missing after that first round, you keep going back to the lemon line until the last player to score is left, and they get to take one big bite out of the lemon.
And all of that is a tasty reason for the All-Star and his club to think big this postseason.
I believe in all my teammates and myself to be able to make it all the way.
Marty Cesario, Prep Spotlight TV.
Yeah, baby!